Alright, so in this video I'm going to be telling you guys how you can get a 30-day visa extension in Thailand. I specifically did it in Phuket. The last time I did it in Bangkok, it took me a few hours because I think Bangkok has only one immigration office, which is Luxy Plaza, so the queue times were insane. But here in Phuket, the whole process from me arriving to the immigration office, me getting my photocopies, then queuing in line, took under 1 hour. So you're gonna need three things before you head there, or you can get these three things done over there. You're gonna need your passport photo, like a cut-out passport photo. You can do it at the immigration office. They always have like a little stand or shop where you can get your photocopies done and your passport photos taken. You're gonna need photocopies of your passport. You're gonna need a photocopy of the front page of your passport. Then you're gonna need a photocopy of the entry stamp. Then when you got into Thailand, you're gonna need that photocopy of your entry stamp. And then you're gonna need a TM30 form, which either your hotel or your landlord, like let's say you're staying at an Airbnb, can provide for you. So you're gonna need these three things. The TM30 is the most important because, like I said, you need to get it at the reception of your hotel or you need to get it from your landlord. Now in Bangkok, I didn't need the TM30, but here they did ask for it. So it's always best to be prepared. The photocopies that you can get your photocopies of your passport done very cheap at the immigration office. It was around 3 baht for per photocopy. So I paid 6 baht for two photocopies, which is literally cents. Like it's literally pennies. And then after you have those three things, you're going to need to bring a pen with you, most importantly as well, because they don't provide pens over there. So bring a pen with you because there's three forms that you need to fill out. There's like the TM7 form and some other forms that you need to fill out before you begin the process. And that's literally all you need. Here in Phuket, for example, there are multiple immigration offices where you can get your visa extended or visa extended. I'll just be showing you guys on Google Maps the location I did mine, and then you can just check on Google which immigration office is closest to your accommodation here in Phuket. I think, like I said, in Bangkok and in different parts of Thailand, there's only certain immigration offices that will do it. So I would highly suggest you guys do your own research depending on where you're located in Thailand and where to extend. And I highly recommend you guys do the visa extension anywhere other than Bangkok, because when I was in Bangkok, it took me like 6 or 7 hours. Now I made a short little vlog about me going to the immigration office, yada, yada, yada. So if you guys are interested in that, then you can watch that. But all the important information I will put in the beginning of the video, so I don't want to waste your time. There you go. All right, your boy got his passport photos. I'm gonna quickly head to the reception, ask for the TM30 form, and we're gonna be heading to the Phuket immigration office to try and get the 30-day visa extension. It's currently 12:30, a little bit later than I wanted, but generally between 12 and 1, every immigration office has their lunch break, so it's closed during those hours. And the immigration office I'm heading to closes at 4:30, so it should give me ample time to then go get my photocopies of my passport and then apply for the 30-day visa extension, which you can also get the photocopies done and generally at the immigration offices themselves. There's always generally like shops where you can even get your passport photos taken and your photocopies of your passport. So let's quickly head on this mission. Your boy got his TM30 printed at the hotel reception, just proof of residence. Always better to be over prepared than under. Like I said, in Bangkok, when I did the last time, I didn't need it. But this time around, since I'm in a different part of the island, I think it's just better to be safe than sorry, right? So then I've ordered a Grab right now, and then we're going to be heading 12 kilometers for the price of like 176 baht to the immigration office that is open until 4:30 p.m. I think there's one in Patong Beach as well, which might be a little bit closer to me, but that's only open until 3 p.m. And since it's already 12:53, almost 1 p.m., I'm a little bit afraid that I won't have enough time over there, especially if there's a long ass queue. Right, so now we are on the way to the immigration office, and I'm going to be filming some of the journey there for you guys and doing my little edits.
Always around me, always.
The immigration office, as you guys see, I'm gonna go get my photocopies of my passport taken. Otherwise, I have a passport photo and then I have the proof of residency. And yeah. As you guys see over here, we have just extended the visa. The entire process from the moment I got here to, filling out the paperwork to queuing in line took me under 1 hour. When I did this in Bangkok, it took me, I arrived in Bangkok at like 9 o'clock, at 9 in the morning at the Luxy Plaza immigration office, and I only got out around like 3 p.m. So in Bangkok, it took me the whole day, because I think in Bangkok, they only have one immigration office, which is Luxy Plaza. So the queue and the line was insanely long. And man, the Bangkok process was a nightmare, but here in Phuket, it was a lot faster. So I recommend, if you guys wanna get a 30-day extension visa for Thailand, to do it at any other office or any other area than Bangkok. As you guys see, I got my blue. So for the 30-day visa extension, they're going to add the 30 days onto when you were supposed to leave the country, not 30 days when you went to the office. So for example, you can arrive to Bangkok your first day, and if your first day, if it's early enough and you have enough time, you can go and get your 30-day visa extension for another 30 days from the time that you were supposed to leave. So well, I arrived September 6th. I'm supposed to leave October 5th, and they're adding the 30 days onto the October 5th date. For the future, I'm going to be looking at a longer term rental, whether it's like Airbnb or maybe I'll find someone through Facebook for a 1 month rental. That's relatively cheaper than staying at a hotel, so that I can cut down on those costs. So as you guys see, September, this is when I arrived to the country, and now I have the extension until November 4th. So your boy is gonna be here for a little while longer. And I'm also looking at extending my visa longer than 30 days. But if I do that, then I'm gonna be doing that through one of the visa agencies so that they can help me through that process. And I'll be updating you guys on that. But for now, right now, we're just gonna relax and chill. I'm not in a rush to do that. But I'd like to look into that maybe at the beginning of next month or towards the end of this month. Yo. We got some guys over there that were in the visa immigration office as well. So now we're gonna chill over here, man. Back from the immigration office, got the 30-day extension. I'm gonna go find a place to eat and then edit this vlog. I hope you guys found this vlog somewhat entertaining. I'll put all the useful information in the beginning. Once again, my favorite spot to eat, we're gonna opt in for the chicken and rice. That's really all I eat. Chicken and rice, pork and rice, shrimp and rice, anything with protein and rice. And then, yeah, edit the vlog and catch you guys on the next one. so good, man. I can eat this meal every day for every single meal.